Hey guys, welcome to Cooking with Priya on this Sunday afternoon. I am totally bumming still in my jogging clothes. Not even joking. I was like, I'm not gonna go change. I'm just gonna cook and then go take another shower. Don't ask. It's just my Sunday bumming. I spent most of the weekend indoors, right? Doing closets, cleaning house, and here I am cooking. Hey Mona, how are you? Mona, you cooked up a storm today. I was like, oh, I love it. I love everything you did. So I jogged, I cleaned, I'm like doing a million things. Hey babes, and I'm like, okay, I gotta cook now because, you know, we gotta eat. Yesterday my aunt actually cooked, so I didn't have to cook. I skipped out and we had soup, we had late night sushi. Anyway, I got indie music today, right? I was like, it's Sunday, I'm feeling it. I was like, I'm playing it today. So let me tell you guys what I'm making. Just some quick stuff, right? So hold on, all of a sudden it's too loud. I'm just gonna do some bora. So I've got some bora here. So I've got some quarantine shrimp from Guyana. My aunt hooked me up. I'm sure you're tired now. I did my stuff and I'm cooking late. Potato, some tomato, onions, and a pepper. And I'm gonna chop this up, show you guys. I'm just gonna fry bora. I already have rice, and guess what? My aunt made roti and brought it for me. So I don't have to make any of that stuff. So I'm like, I'm gonna come hang with you guys and I'm actually gonna do a quick quesadilla cause you know, the girls, they just want quesadilla. So I'm like, okay, I'll do quesadilla, I'll fry bora and shrimp and what else am I making? And a cocktail for you guys. So that should be fun. So I'm like, all right, I could just stay in my gym clothes and come cook. So I'm like, not even a big deal. Hey Susan, how are you? Everyone cook early, right? And I was like looking at all these posts and I'm like, I'm so lazy right now. I'm like, I'm cooking late. I'm not cooking early. I'm like, I'm just gonna do it late, like when I'm done doing everything. So we'll have food. Usually I like cooking early as well. I gotta get garbage for this, hold on. Just gonna throw it in like another plate or something. So I'm like, and usually I like to do like, I ask the girls, I'm like, do you want barbecue? Do you want, hi Lucinda, how are you? Do you want barbecue? Do you want, you know, this? They're like, nah, we don't, thank you so much. They're like, nah. So I was like, all right, I've made fried bora a lot of times. And I noticed the bora too when I buy it from Queens. And you bring it and you keep it for like 2 days, it starts going bad. And I don't want my bora to go bad. I'm like, I used some in my chow mein the other day and I'm like, okay, I gotta like finish up my bora. This one actually didn't go bad. I guess they didn't put as much chemicals in it, so. Oh yeah, believe it or not, bora is like one of my favorite too. Or what you would call like, I guess some people call it like Asian long beans. I know some of my friends who are not West Indian, that's what they call it. So I'm letting you guys watch me chop bora. Everything's already washed, right? So Susan, I love the food you made today. Amazing. I love everyone that's on the One Guyana food page. I love it. It's so amazing. I was looking today and I was like, oh yes, everyone's cooking. Everyone's having a good time. I'm like, I better cook later on. So I was like, yeah, I'm just gonna come on and do a video and hang with you guys. Hey Zahira, how are you? And I'm like, definitely feeling some Indian music today. So my little Avery is becoming obsessed with these Indian videos and music because my aunt's got her into it. Listen, I love my culture, but I love every kind of music, right? I don't just like one thing. I listen to everything. Hey Sharita, how are you? Frying bora with shrimp and potato and making a quesadilla because that's how the house is. Somebody wants Guyanese, somebody wants, you know, a quesadilla. That's just how it works in here. Mom's got her gym clothes on still. It's Sunday. It's like clean closet, clean house. I literally did not leave the house all weekend long just because always so much to do, right? Always so much to do. So I'm like, I'm gonna come on, and usually I prep before, but I'm like, I'm just gonna come on and actually just chill with you guys today and chat while I cook. And I always say, like, when I'm cooking bora, it's, I'm always there's a key to it, right? You just make sure you put it on low heat because you definitely don't want it to you don't want it to catch, right? So any vegetable I notice, as long as you put it on like low heat, that should be fine. So just gonna chill and do that today. And I'm like, I have this really, I was like looking at my food basket. I'm like, what fruit do I have? Like, what am I making today? I'm gonna be squinting just now. I put my glasses on to read comments. I can see fine. As soon as I start reading comments, I'm like, I start squinting. Oh, now Susan, you can make me put my glasses on because I cannot see all of that you just wrote just now. I'm like, I'm definitely gonna be blinded. Hold on, these things need to be clean. Like, I can read one or two, right? As soon as the whole thing pops up, I'm gonna be like this. Oh yeah, I know, Susan. It's okay. I know the time just flies. I swear. Okay, let me see. Oh yeah, she did. You know what's funny with mom? She probably wasn't wearing her glasses, right? So I don't. As you know, I love you for cooking hasa, Mona, but I don't eat hasa, right? No gilbaka, no catfish, no hasa, none of that stuff. Mom must have thought that maybe the page, the posting was probably mine. I bet you mom didn't even realize that that was your. I thought that was so hilarious. I talked to mom, but I forgot to ask her. So I thought that was pretty funny. I was like, I bet mom's like, hasa? Like, how come she, she doesn't even eat hasa? How come there's hasa on there? I'm like, I bet mom thought that maybe something random happened. And she's like, I'm coming over. I thought it was so funny. Hi Helen. It was funny. Wait till I saw her later. I'm telling you, mom probably didn't even realize. She's probably like, this gal that eat hasa, how come she's cooking hasa? Oh my god. That's a good fun joke for Sunday, right? But mom likes hasa, right? I've had it when I was younger, and then as I got older, I just don't eat it. So that's it. Helen, I am making Bora quesadilla. It's like, this is the house. This is the American Guyanese house. Quesadilla and Bora, and then a cocktail. Yeah, that was too funny. Yeah, mom's pretty amazing. Mom's a good cook, right, Mona? Oh man. Mom, my Aunt Vashti, my Auntie Janet, my mom's sisters, and my grandmother. Oh, forget it. I heard my aunt saying, like most families growing up in Guyana, you know, they were poor as well. And my aunt goes, she was like, we couldn't afford everything. But let me tell you right now, like when people, like when it came to food, grandma would buy, nanny would buy like the best fish at the market. Nanny would buy like the best things because food was always a thing. So it was only inevitable with the granddaughter to turn out like this, right? To become like a crazy foodie. Yeah, so that was like the thing. When they went to the market, I heard. I love hearing stories about Guyana. And especially them growing up in Guyana. It's so fun. Because I didn't grow up there for a lot of my life. But whatever. You know, I was like 6, 7 when I got here, so it's okay. It's all good. It's all good. Hey, Sunita, how are you? Sunita, you're right. I probably see you more on Facebook than I see you in person. Sunita, what'd you make today? I know you're always making something good on Sundays, like your famous curry duck curry. I'm just frying up some bora. And like I said, I have rice and I have roti, so I was like debating, should I make it early? Should I do my chores? I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna do my chores and then cook and shower and then just relax. And then we'll have it hot because we had other stuff we had for lunch and breakfast. Sorry if this is like taking a long time. I didn't realize. And that's literally, I was like, shoot, should I add more shrimp to it? Because I have no more shrimp, right? I was like, that's all I have. What I have is what I use. And then I started looking around my fruit bowl. I'm like, what kind of fruit do I have? What kind of cocktail can I make for you guys? I think I've made this cocktail before, which is a dragon fruit, but I'm actually making a yellow dragon fruit today. So that's gonna be a little better. Actually, here we go. Oh, okay. So you skip that under cooking. All right. Hold on, I should do a couple of these. Put my hair up. Okay, so I am just going to get all washed up right now and get started with my boro. So that's what's going on with that. Wash my hands up and do that. I probably put my hair up too. Definitely don't want boro stains really like in my hair for sure. And my clip went flying, right? Like literally. Okay, hold on. So when I start frying, there's like no food in my, there's no hair in my food. There we go. Put that on. Okay, so I just got my oil like heated up here, right? So I'm going to just get all my ingredients that I showed you guys earlier, and I'm just going to just pop it in the pan and get going with that. So hold on. So first, I just want to like saute my onions, right? So that's going in there first. So there we go. And I've got, like I was telling you, I have a couple of seasoning here. I just have some garlic powder, black pepper, paprika, and I've got salt and a little bit of tomatoes and my shrimp. And my potato and my pepper. And of course, my boro, right? I think people in Guyana have this for like breakfast. I'm having it for dinner. It's okay. It's all good. It's all good. So I'm just gonna fry this up. And while this is frying up, then I'll be doing my my quesadilla, and then I'll make a cocktail. And then that should be it. Should be done for the day, really quick. So, hold on. So literally just frying up my shrimp now. And it's just literally like a little bit, right? Throw my tomatoes in there. And I'm just gonna throw a little bit of seasoning. Not a lot, just some garlic salt. I love smoked paprika and everything, I swear. I probably use the same ingredients for everything, but it's because I like it. A little bit of paprika and a little bit of black pepper. And sticking this back in here in my canister so I can just get that out of the way. Turn this up, and because it's like pre-cooked, right, the shrimp, the Guyana red shrimp, so it's like it cooks really fast. It gives it like the most amazing flavor ever, I tell you. And I'm just literally going to add my potatoes to this. So there we go. Turning this up. Hold on, make sure you guys can see this a little better. There we go. I'm gonna salt it up when I add my boro to it. And I was saying, like, the key to boro is just like cover it and put it on low heat, right? Like, that's the whole point of it. Like, just doing that. Add that. And literally, I have like a pepper. Just throwing that in. Just to let it steam. Definitely lowering this now. Hi, Ahilia, how are you? So here we go, just salting this up. Just because it has potato, I'm just putting a little extra salt, that's all. Turn this up. And this is getting thrown onto a different burner because I'm switching it up. because it needs to be on low heat. Put my grill pan on for the quesadilla. And I definitely want to cover it too. Watch me not find the cover. I think I got it. I think I washed it. Hold on. Oh, okay. Bedtime, I know. It's early over the baby, yeah, I'm sure. I'm sure. Hold on, yeah, so I'm just gonna like cover that and get going here, like that. Okay, there we go. So letting this heat up, and I'm going to just add, either you could add Pam or you know, cooking spray, or you could just add oil, like whatever. Doesn't even matter. So I'm just gonna spray this up, and this will be for the quesadilla for the grilled chicken breast. I know. I was like, and then I realized I'm like, oh, it's the baby. It's bedtime for the baby. So you definitely want this really heated. And I'm also going to make a quick guac to go with it. I have sour cream and guac. Like, I've just got three chicken breasts because I'm just making like one big one. Like only Chalisa and Avery will probably have that. So let that heat up, and it's just thin chicken breasts. And this is really thin cut, so it'll like, it's not the thick one, so it'll really like just grill really fast. That's it. And I've literally made like quesadilla on here before, so you definitely know how this is. So I'm just gonna make guac right now and show you guys. You know how that is too, but there we go. In the backyard. Okay, so here we go. So really quick, actually I just gotta grab another knife. Just grab a cleaner knife. Just take all this stuff off my board. Give me a second. So I've just got an avocado. Grab this. I've got some plum tomatoes here. You can use anything you want. And some cilantro and a lime. And literally, like, I just stuck everything in the bowl, right? Like, really quick. So, let me get this wiped down. And just salt and pepper and some, I hope this is good. Because I had only one left, so let's see. I think I had the other one. Oh, it is good. Good. So I'm just going to do that. And take it out. I feel like, do I need more light? Is that better? Yeah, I think that's a little better. Scoop that up. And I feel like every time we have quesadilla, like, we need guac, right? Or some kind of, something with, like, we need something avocado-ish, like. It works. Woo-hoo! Just pour this up. Just do this lightly so it doesn't go all the way through, so you're not like, you know, poking your hands through or anything. And it just scoops out really fast. I always have a lot of avocado because it's so, you know, it's so good for you. We usually have it like breakfast and everything else. We always have avocado around the house like crazy. The chicken's literally like grilling up so fast. And I'm gonna just squeeze some lime over it so it doesn't get like dark right away, right? Just about a quarter of a lime. I don't want my chicken to burn. I'm taking you guys back with me. Definitely. Definitely don't want this to burn. See that? It's so thin, it just cooks up really fast. Really, really fast. Mm-hmm. cooking, but I love cooking when it's like quick too, right? Like, if I was making dal and rice stuff today, forget it. I would be like in the kitchen sleeping still. Hold on. Not that I mind at all, but some days it's just like, okay. And I'm just cutting these tomatoes just really small. Just cutting them in four. And these are plum tomatoes. They're kind of big. I'm trying one. Mmm, really sweet. Really, really sweet. What's going on, Nani? How are you? I see you're on watching. You probably cook like 50 things today. Hey, Mahanti, how are you? Some more tomato. And these are bright and red, but like they look really good when you put them with the avocado. So that's what's going on with that. And now I'm just gonna do a garlic. And literally I'm gonna like probably take my chicken off in a minute, right? Just smashing my garlic up. Okay, you can leave it. Yeah. No. So stick that in there. You can see they're outside. And I've got some red onions or purple onions, whatever you want to call them. I'm just gonna chop this up fine. Add this to it. Just add this. Not too much, right? Just a little bit. And my chicken, believe it or not, it's already done while I'm making this. I will tell the wine you said hi. I will say hi to him. He just came home from Queens. So I will definitely tell him. So just sticking my chicken breast in here. So that's that. Devon never wants to be in my videos, right? Or have anything to do with, he just wants to eat. He's like, he wants nothing to do with being in any of this. I'm going to check on, my Bora. Oh, there we go. Cooking up nicely, let me show you guys. Look at that. Definitely cooking up very, very, very nice. And just literally like three chicken breasts, like not even a big deal. I'm just gonna finish up my guac with you guys. So this is what it's looking like so far. So colorful and pretty. And just add in some cilantro, right? You definitely gotta have some cilantro in this. Can't have this without cilantro. Just chopping up some cilantro really fine. Cilantro to that, and what else? Just some salt and pepper and some hot sauce. You need some Tabasco in this, just not even for heat, just for flavor, and just a little bit. And I'm gonna grab the salt and a little bit of salt. Voila. And like a nice quick hey Drew. A nice quick guac, just to put, you know, you could put it in the quesadilla, or you could just, of course, have it on the side, like I would with a little bit. I would have it inside or outside, doesn't matter, whatever the girls want. But, and just put it with a little bit of sour cream and call it a day. And then we'll have Bora with roti or rice, whichever, we have both. So that's that. I don't like when my bowl looks dirty, right? Like, I have a huge problem with that. Like, I've got to definitely, like, wipe it down or something. Like, I have this, I'm a little OCD. If you know me, you would know that. I'm a little OCD with things, so just leave it like that and whatever. There it is, like a paste almost. Guacamole, quesadilla, and boron shrimp with potato and a cocktail coming up. Cocktail is definitely for you guys. Love doing that for you guys these days. That's always like a fun thing. I'm like, gotta definitely get my viewers going with a cocktail. It's become fun. And I just like making them too, right? Not for nothing. I just like making them too. I'm like, I gotta find music while I'm on with you guys. So I'm cleaning up while I'm going, right? That's my usual. Because I don't want to be stuck in here doing this after. Oh, you too? Hold on. Oh, yeah. Just like really, really simple. I'm backing up over here. While I'm getting my garbage. I'm going to wash up. Hold on. I wipe my board down so I can... Hey, Joni, how are you? Wipe my board down so I can probably do my quesadilla on here. I mean, I just like keeping this board in the kitchen anyway, because it's just easy, right? And it's big, so kind of just like wipe it down. Don't really wet it that much at all. Just most of the time wiping it down. Hi, baby. What are you getting, water? Okay. Do you need help? Are you sure? Okay. You need ice? Is it that hot out?
No. I did
pepper
chicken.
Oh, Shalisa ate pepper chicken from Queens. So it's so spicy. Her whole face. She ran in here for, Shalisa's a trip. She ran in here for water. All right, let me get my chicken to chop it up with you guys. So here's my chicken breast. So you'll have quesadilla after, Shalisa? Yeah? Okay. Do you want to close the door, lovey? Hi, Avery. Are you a sweat box? Yeah. Do you want to say hi? Is that your hi? Oh, you've been napping. I know, it's a good day to nap. Hey, Rafina. Hey, Sandra. So I'm just cutting this up. You okay, babes? Huh? Yeah? Yeah, well, maybe you shouldn't have any more pepper chicken. That's probably too spicy for you, love bug. Mommy's gonna make you, please don't have that. Okay? Sorry, mommy duties. Gotta talk to them while I talk to you guys. It's the usual. You could just have quesadilla and guacamole after. Okay, baby? Oh my God. She's like, the girl turned red, right? And she eats spicy. This is my spicy girl. So that must have been really spicy. So just putting this all back into the bowl. Putting this all back into the bowl. And I gotta, of course, keep turning my bora, right? Because I don't want it to burn at all. Leaving this. Gotta wipe my board down again. Oh yeah, Jizzy wants some milk. Huh? Mommy's friend Susan said, Auntie said you should have some milk. It'll take away the burn. Yeah, she's like, okay. Susan's child's like, the thing must have really burned her. Okay. She said, okay. Let me know, baby. Oh my God, she's too much. You sure? You wanna have it? Just maybe a little bit. Maybe a little bit. Maybe it'll cool your mouth out. Just a tiny. You wanna just have a little before you go, please? Oh God. God, guys. Sorry. Thank you for the tip, Susan. Thanks. Like a couple of sips, baby. Auntie said like a couple of sips. Susan, thank you. I didn't even know that. Is it working? Susan, she says it's working. So thank you for that. I had no clue. Good? Okay. Sorry, what are you sorry about? Something happened, it's not a big deal.
That was spicy though.
I told the girl to put extra spice. Well, you don't need extra spice.
Not for my spicy girl.
Oh, for your spicy girl? Well, your spicy girl can't handle that. You gotta tell him. That's too spicy for you, baby. I thought you were napping, Avi. I had no idea. I know. Hey, Susan, you're addicted to pepper. So I don't really eat pepper, right? Actually, I told your brother that. Stop eating pepper. No good for you right now. So anyway, I know. I think it's like an acquired taste for people. I think it makes the food taste better in some cases, but you know. Really not too good. All right. You done? Okay. All right.
Bye.
Thank you. Oh, Susan, she said thank you. She's out of here. She's back on the roll outside. So at least it worked, Jaleesa. At least it worked. So that was great. Still turning my boar, right? It's a good thing my boar is on low heat. Good thing I have to cook it on low heat. Because this is the thing. There's always something going on, right? Sorry, I just put my tortilla on, by the way. Just letting this heat up. I'm going to put the next one on. I'm going to fill it. Oh, this is like already, yeah. Popping up here. Let this one go. Let it go like that. And I'm just going to fill it now. Just with chicken. And cheese, and then the girls will have like sour cream, or you can have everything else on the side, it doesn't matter. It was too spicy for her. It was too spicy for her, like way too spicy for her. Yeah, so this is what this is looking like right here. And I'm going to put, you could put like, oh, thanks again, you could put like, shredded cheese. I just like monster cheese because it's super, super melty, right? So I'm gonna put monster on there. You could put mozzarella too or whatever you have. I just like the monster cheese. There's a lot of stretching going on with it, so I have a hard time flipping this back. Oh, these are tortillas of, they look like roti, right? They're like Latin, like yeah, they're tortillas. It's like a, maybe like a Spanish roti. Get crispy at the bottom, and I'm gonna flip it. And then I'll cut it into like squares that look like a pizza almost. So, and then they'll just have it with something else. Hold on, let me find something else. So, okay, so let's see. Oh my God. Oh, good. Yeah, that was a great tip. I hope everyone else that's watching knows my friend Susan just hooked me up with a great tip just now that I had no idea about. I just flipped my chicken and my tortilla and it didn't go all over the place. So that's good. Good vibes today. Still checking on my boar. My boar is frying up. Actually, it's probably going to be done soon because the potatoes like cooked down and everything already. Just gonna turn this up just a little bit. just let this keep going, and I'm gonna put it in. Oh, thanks, Av. Yeah, it's great. Av, I miss you. I miss my talking to you. You see, I'm still wearing my jogging clothes. I was like, oh, I'm done cooking, then I'm gonna go shower again. It was like, I'm just like chilling right now. The cheese is like definitely getting all stretchy and nice in here. Definitely doing that. And let me see my tortilla in the bottom. I don't want it to burn, so it's actually it's like it's done, believe it or not. I'm going to like try to stick it on my board so I can cut it. Hold on. Bring this over so you guys will be able to see it better. There we go. That's that. And let me get something to... Just get like a pizza cutter or whatever. Aww. So, something just fell. I'm just gonna cut this, right? And then I'll plate it up. There we go. Ha, 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 ha. I could do four, or I could do, you know, you cut it however. The girls are little, so I'll probably cut it back. I just don't want it to fall apart. Probably try to cut it like one more time. And this thing is really sharp, so should get like good angles of cutting it, the pizza cutter. There we go, and I'm literally going to try one more time. Yeah, so it'll be, yeah, nice and little. Oh, hold on, I gotta read. Oh yeah, really? I wish I had a story like that, Mona. But thank you for sharing. There we go. To show you guys, like, that's what's going on with that. Probably gonna just like stick it, try to see if I can get it on a plate. I have no idea if I could get it on the plate, right? Let's see. Maybe another spatula. Maybe another big spatula. Got on the spatula on the plate, like without an issue, right? So there, they'll just have that, right? That is too funny. And I'm going to not put everything on it because the girls won't want everything on it. I'm gonna grab a plate and have one and show you guys how I set mine up. It would be good if I checked on my board, right? Hold on. Let me just check on it again. Oh, my board is done. That's what's going on in here. Like, the potato's cooked and it's cooked down, so that's done. Yep. Let me grab a plate and show you guys what's going on with this. My quesadilla. So, hold on. I happen to love quesadilla too, right? Not just the kids. And I would just like stick some guacamole on top. And you know what else I would put on top? I do have a story actually, right? I forgot. I do have the masala bread. I totally forgot about that. I didn't even realize. I'm telling you, sometimes the ditziness kicks in me and I forget things. I did show my masala bread a few times, so that was really good. And I'm telling you, the curry comes out like so much better. Let me grab some sour cream for this. And I'm just gonna put like a little bit of sour cream on it. If it wants to like come off of this spoon. Okay, so this is what's going on with this. Hey Andre, how are you? So I'm going in for the dive, right? With my big mouth, so don't mind me. So good. And so light and fresh. This is really good. That's really good. I almost want to eat like the whole thing with you guys. That's really good. I like that. Never fails when you make stuff like this, right? Probably have quesadilla, probably have a piece of roti or rice with bora. Who knows? I'll figure it out as I go. So I'm gonna make a fun cocktail with you guys. I got it all set up. Hold on. All set up right now. And I'm changing my music, right? I'm changing my song right now. I'm going Indian all the way today, but I'm going to leave it. Leave something good on. So hold on, let me back this up. Make sure you guys could see me. So what I've got, hold on, gotta make sure you guys can see. So what I've got going on here is I have a yellow dragon fruit. Usually they're red, but oh, is it your favorite? I know in Canada they have this a lot, right? We usually get the red one here. I found a yellow one, so I'm like, I'm just gonna use this. So this is what it looks like. So what I'm going to do is just grab a bowl. And I'm going to put some in here. And I'm gonna get my shaker. I'm gonna muddle some. And then I'll cube some for my glass. So let me just peel this and show you. Where? She's coming? Okay. Yes. I can't hear you. Tell me. To where?
Yeah, from
the bathroom. Okay. You're going now? You're going. But she has to get. Just give me like 5 minutes, please. Okay. The girls want to go somewhere. I just want to know where they're going, what they're doing. Okay, so first I'm going to just cube some. So it looks nice. Throw some in there. So I'm just going to, I'm cubing some and I'm throwing it in my glass. I'm taking just maybe a slice here and throwing it in my shaker. I need to grab a tissue. So this is in here, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to squeeze some lime in here. I do have the lime squeezer, but it's okay. I'll just use my hands. It's not a big deal. A little bit of lime and a little bit of mint. It's like a dragon fruit mojito, right? Basically, that's what it is. Just throw some mint leaves in here. Okay. definitely don't want the stem. So that's what that's looking like. Maybe one more. It's minty, fresh, nice flavors. And just gonna muddle this. Oh my God, Susan, it's so good. It's so sweet. And it's really good for you too, Susan. Got a lot of good health benefits to it. So that's what that's looking like. So I've got some vodka here. Throwing some vodka in there. And I made simple syrup. So this is just sugar, water, like organic sugar, whatever sugar, just white sugar with water. That's going in there. And of course, I'm going to do ice, right? I'm gonna grab some ice from my fridge. Get some ice there. Put some ice in here as well. Maybe not as much in my glass. Because I wanna like see it, right? I wanna be able to see my my dragon fruit in my glass. I want it to look pretty. So, but I want it to be cool as well. Oh God. Believe it or not, Susan, I'll tell you what I drink. I drink wine. Like, I'm a wine and champagne drinker. I'm not, and I had my first drink when I was like 23 or something. Hey son, how are you? And I drink wine. I do make cocktails and then I just pass it on. I'm not a drinker. I do taste it though. I taste it for you guys. And now I like making it for you guys on here. So that's always fun. So that goes here. And I'm just gonna shake this. Hold on. And this is glass, right? So I don't wanna like make it all crazy. And then I'll just garnish it with like a mint leaf after and show you guys. So shake it. I feel like that's chicken stuck in my teeth. So see that? Just gonna pour that out now. Is I'm just going to do some Schweppes after, because that's all vodka, right? And simple syrup. So going to add this to it, and then I'm going to add just like a mint leaf. This one's sinking. I need like a bigger one, like a bigger piece to make it look pretty. So there we go. The music stopped, right? So it's like really quiet in here all of a sudden. It's like I'm playing a song I really like right now. And I mean, it's summertime, so there's no other way to do it than this song right now. And end it with a cocktail. It's like the music was perfect for the cocktail right now. Look at this. See that? You see the dragon fruit? I'm gonna grab a straw, actually. Hold on. And I'm literally going to taste this and tell you guys how it is. It is like the beginning of an endless summer, an endless year, I tell you. I'm gonna tell you guys something before I taste this for you guys. I know we've been on lockdown all over the world. And I literally started doing this because this is what I do. I cook for my family daily. And I just started doing this and cooking live, and I love it, and I love everything about it. And this has probably been one of the best years of my life, believe it or not, in these terrible situations. I try to find the best and the positive in a lot of situations, right? And I've probably met like some of the best people I've ever met in my life, and became friends with the most amazing people, and just the love and support I've gotten from, you know, people I just met this year. I can't even tell you, and it means the world to me. My heart is so filled, I couldn't even tell you. And just try to take it with a grain of salt in every situation we're in, just try to find a positive in it. And you can never know when a stranger or something or someone could come into your life and totally change it. And I hope I come into your home and cook with you from my kitchen and inspire you as well to make creative dishes as an American Guyanese that, you know, that can't wait to visit Guyana so I could get more in touch with my roots. So I just wanted to say thank you to everyone that's watching and for all your supports, all your comments and everything. And I am actually looking forward to Priya's Kitchen going to a level that that I would like to see it to be. So I just wanted to tell you guys that on that note. And literally just sometimes the simplest things, you know, there's always a beginning with little things and you never know what can come out of it. So always try to stay positive. That's probably the teacher in me talking right now. But anyway, it is like an endless summer. We have great weather and just be thankful for everything you have. Thank you for hanging with me this Sunday so much. I can't even tell you. I appreciate every minute of it. And I'm going to try this so you guys can just know how it is. Okay, it's good. I mean, not because I made it, it's good. It's good. It's pretty good. It's just gonna sit there though, but it's good. So anyway, always keep good vibes going. Please share this page because it does help. And check out our page, the One Guyana Food Festival, my friends Susan, Mona, you know, Jersey Jimmy, Vaco, everyone, Marisha, and of course Mr. Snow. We are all indebted to him because he's just an amazing human being. So just wanted to say that and check us out and always keep good vibes going. Enjoy the rest of your Sunday and hopefully I'll see you guys soon. Ciao. Thanks for cooking with Priya and Priya's Kitchen.